So I picked up the phone one day, and on the other end, I heard a familiar voice ask me this question: "Randy, did you know that Jesus dies 4 times in the Bible?" Now, at that point, I had been a pastor in Silver Lake Church in Los Angeles for a few years. I had also been leading Bible studies in Mexico City, in Honduras, in Mozambique, in Zimbabwe, in South Carolina, and I had never, ever been asked that question before. It was a great question, and I loved it, but I also was a little bit confused by it, and I think the voice on the other end of the phone could tell. So she explained. She said, "Well, you see, Jesus dies in Matthew, Jesus dies in Mark, Jesus dies in Luke, and Jesus dies in the Gospel of John." And so I explained to her that those weren't actually 4 different lives of Jesus, but instead it was one life of Jesus, but 4 different books of the Bible about that one life of Jesus. But the question underneath what she was asking still remains: why are there four books of Jesus' one life in the Bible at all? Why does the Bible do this? Hi, I'm Randy Lovejoy with randylovejoy.com, and this is another Under the Hood video where we test assumptions that are behind our beliefs, our assumptions, our decisions, so that we can make more strategic and wiser choices in our lives that will actually create good in this crazy time of change that we find ourselves in. So there are 4 books in the Bible, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, that are in a way duplicates of the one life of Jesus. But these are not the only duplicates in the Bible. You can look it up on the web, and you'll see all sorts of different verses or books that overlap. There are a number of duplicates in the Bible, and that's really not a problem for the Bible. And it hasn't been a problem for a lot of other people that have read the Bible in different times and places, but it is a problem for us. It bothers us. Now, why does it bother us? Well, it has to do with the way that we read the Bible. Because think about it. Any of the really, really good stories that are police stories or mystery stories, you know, when there's some crime, what the police want is they want more than one witness, they want multiple witnesses. And the other thing you learn after you watch for a while is that if all of the multiple witnesses tell the story in the exact same way, then clearly they're rehearsed and you're not learning the truth. So you want multiple witnesses, one's not enough, you want 2 or 3 or 4, and it's actually better to have multiple witnesses with stories that vary when you're looking for the truth. So what we need to do is to take that framework that we're using when we're watching a police show or a murder mystery, and we need to use that same framework with the Bible. Let's think about the Bible in the same way. We have 4 witnesses to the life of Jesus. And Jesus' life isn't just any life. I mean, if you think about it, Jesus' life was a life that actually, no matter what you think about Jesus' life actually changed the human conception of time. Just think for a minute about BC and AD, before Christ and in the year of our Lord, Anno Domini, AD. That alone shows that the impact that this individual had on human history is massive. And so what we've got is we've got 4 witnesses, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, to this life of Jesus. They are all different. John is more different than Matthew, Mark, and Luke are, but the structure of their story, what the story is about, is in common, the same thing. They're about the life of the same man. And if you just think of it in terms of historical impact and try to prioritize what you read according to the stuff that's really made a difference in the world, then it makes total sense that every human being on the planet should take the time to read these 4 stories that are found in the Bible and listen to those 4 different witnesses and think about the truth of this man. What do we think about this person, Jesus Christ? Now, that's just the first step. And next week on the Instagram Live on Wednesday morning, I'm going to share other steps that we can take in terms of the Gospels, and that's what they're called, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, the Gospels, and how they can be used in our lives to create good in our lives and relationships and community. But this is the first step, and it's an essential step. You need to take the time to read Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. I'd encourage you to start with Mark just because it's a much faster paced story. It's very, very cut and dry, fast, quick from story to story to story. And then you can kind of toy around with the other ones. John is much more wordy, but I don't mean that in a bad sense. There's a lot more kind of theology. Don't want to scare you away because some people just immediately take to John before they would with the other three. But kind of read a little bit of each one of them and decide which one you want to dive into. Then read the next one and just compare and contrast the story that they're telling about the life of this man. And what I can guarantee you is that wherever you are in your spiritual journey, if you take the time to read Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, it is going to help you move forward in your life. It's those are powerful stories, and regardless of your opinion of whether you affiliate with Christianity or not, you should know these Gospels, and you can really get some good stuff out of these Gospels. Now, one other thing I just want to do in this Facebook Live is to encourage you to become a part of the first digital course that I'm going to be teaching after Easter. And my website should be up very soon, randylovejoy.com. There's an old site there right now. If you keep checking in, you're going to find the newly branded and built website, which is all about the ministry that I'm engaged in now. But this course is called How to Read the Bible to Create Good in Your Life. And this is just one little snippet of what we're going to learn in that course together. So I'd encourage you to be sure to check out the website in the next few weeks. Look for that digital course, sign up and be a part of that as well. But for now, read the Gospels, pick one of them, any one of them, and just read them. And make sure you read it in a translation that's readable for you. You may have the King James on your shelf, but it's tougher for a lot of people to understand because it's an older version of English. So get something like the NIV or NRSV or something like that. And those are different translations, and read those. And then the other thing is, make sure to be here on Wednesday, 8 a.m., Instagram Live, and we will continue the discussion about how these four different stories of the life of Jesus can really help us move forward in our spiritual journey. They can meet us wherever we are right now and help us take the next step forward, regardless of our affiliation. Great to talk with you. Have an awesome day and a great weekend, and we'll talk with you again soon. Bye.